on Pitt.
But let me ask you a question about Pitt. Why does he, there's a choice to be made at the end of the war between the British taking Guadeloupe and Martinique, or, which are French sugar-producing colonies, or Canada. And Canada has, at this point, nothing but a few Frenchmen and this vast wilderness, and yet they choose. Why do you think that Pitt chose
Canada? Well, this was, I mean, Pitt didn't choose. I mean, this is
well, the administration, he was influential.
Well, I mean, so there was a huge debate in Britain about whether or not to give back Guadeloupe and Martinique. And one has to realize, I mean, Guadeloupe and Martinique, we now think of as, you know, nice places to go on holiday. But in the 18th century, they were incredibly productive sugar islands, much more productive, much more efficiently productive in the production of sugar than the British islands of Jamaica or Barbados. So they were fantastically wealthy. The British had conquered them, taken them in the Great Year of Wonders of 1759. Why give them back? Well, there's two positions. The position that Bute and Grenville and others in the administration, like Viscount Barrington, had is if we don't give them back, the French will never agree to peace immediately, and we can't afford to continue fighting the war. And Canada, by contrast, that will consolidate our position in North America. They knew that the French were in negotiations to give Louisiana to the Spanish, so they felt that they would be safe in North America, and they wouldn't have to spend as much money defending the colonies. Pitt's position was, this is crazy. We're, in fact, giving the French the economic resources to rebuild, to refinance, and fight a new war. And this becomes the stuff of the most bitter partisan debate in Britain. In 1762, 1763, the two most influential newspapers, but there were two others that were very influential, were The Briton, written by the novelist Tobias Smollett, which defended the policy, and The North Briton, written by John Wilkes, which was on the Pittite side.
So what other, well, let me add what I think, embellish that. Of course, the end of the war, the French are eliminated from the North American continent. I mean, that's just a basic fact. They retain a couple of islands off of Newfoundland, but essentially the whole of North America up to the Mississippi is now British. So that French presence that, so to speak, the colonists were always aware of, and of course had been they had been engaged in the French and Indian War, are gone, and so that gives them a certain. But in addition to that, now you're going there going to have to be forts, because there's still a French presence in Canada. There has to be forts maintained by the English in the West, in Detroit or Niagara and so on. To protect, presumably protect the colonists or the British territorial hold on this western land. And that's expensive. To maintain a fort like that is expensive. And in fact, Amherst, who is the commander-in-chief, says it's going to cost us, we're going to need 10,000 troops, and the estimated cost was about £300,000 a year. Now that's an enormous amount of money, and as Steve says, the debt, I think at this point, coming out of the war, was £137 million, which is, by today's standards, very small. But the interest on that debt was £5 million a year. And that was the normal peacetime budget for England was about £8 million a year. So £5 million just to pay the interest. We may eventually reach that point, too, if your interest rates start to go up. Suddenly, you've got a situation where you have all of this land that's been acquired that has to be policed, because you can't count on the local militia because there are no Englishmen out there. And you've got Indian presence that are threatening. In fact, the English took over, the British government took over superintending the Indians in the mid-1750s. Up to that time, they'd left it to each of the colonies, the provinces, to do that. So they're aware of the Indians, they're aware of the French presence, you need a military force, you've got tremendous debt, you've got soldiers coming back home saying, wow, those colonists are living in the land of milk and honey, and it's probably true, although it's hard to estimate this, that the highest standard of living, for at least for whites, in the Western world, and that probably means the world, were the American colonists. So you have these, I think, various things coming together that seem normal and certainly imperative that the British tax these people. So that led to, well, first you don't have a tax with the Navigation Act of 1764. It's a kind of tightening up of the of the navigation system, which had bred corruption because there had been a prohibition on the importation of French molasses into North America. The reason for that was the British West Indies, molasses being a byproduct of sugar production, and you can turn it into rum. And the British West Indian planters wanted a monopoly of that, and that's why the Molasses Act of 1733 was passed. No French molasses. The reason the French didn't care about molasses because they didn't want rum to be a rival to their own cognac and wine industry. So this is the way things work. The molasses was coming in all the time in my own state or colony at that point of Rhode Island. Rum manufacturing was a major, major institution. So all of a sudden now, they put a duty on it of 6 pence a gallon, which were a prohibitory duty. It was not designed to raise revenue. Now they lower the duty to 3 pence, and then within a year or so down to 1 pence a gallon. Suddenly, they're gonna make money from it. And instead of trying to prohibit the importation of molasses, since they couldn't do that anyhow, there was corruption everywhere, and the molasses flowed into New England, they are now going to lower and raise money. But that was not objected to on constitutional grounds, because it was simply seen as another aspect of the navigation system, regulating the navigation system, the flow of trade. But the next act, the Stamp Act, was.